Hi, everyone. This is going to be a bit of a departure from my usual content of late. As some of you may know from previous videos, I suffer from the occasional migraine. And mine in particular are kind of nasty. Not that I think there's such a thing as a good migraine. But I suffer from what I've heard termed ocular migraines. And for me, they start with a shimmering geometric pattern in one portion of my vision or another. And it ends up being, it sort of morphs into then a hole in my vision at some point. It's not a hole as in there's a dark spot. There's just an area that I look where I actually have no vision. I can't see something. And so I'm pretty much immediately debilitated at that point. I had a rather nasty one yesterday, really nasty. I'm still recovering from it today. I definitely don't feel 100%. I feel 54% maybe. And what happens is I had this yesterday, and I know to immediately go to bed. So I did that yesterday, immediately went to bed, and I try to get to sleep, but usually I can't because there's sort of some anxiety that goes along with it. I've been getting these since I was a kid, but they have changed over the last bunch of years. I used to get really, really serious splitting headache pain along with it as well, which I don't get anymore. I do get a headache, but it's more of a dull, throbbing tension in my neck and headache in the temples. But what happens is after I lay down for a while, pretty soon one of my hands starts to go numb, and then usually my lips and my tongue and the roof of my mouth. The last time I had a migraine, which actually I did another migraine Monday recuperation video. It was in, I think, rather maybe around my 10th video upload, or it was in the first bunch of videos I'd uploaded to YouTube. And it takes a while to recover. It can take days. Yesterday was particularly disturbing because it lasted for 6 or 7 hours itself. And what happened was, even after the numbness in this hand went away, the numbness in my face and mouth, and then the numbness goes to my other hand, to my right hand, after a while that all passes. But when I got up out of bed after 4 or 5 hours, I have this real disconnected sensation. I feel I've got this heavy, heavy brain fog that doesn't seem to want to lift. So the dog was outside barking. He was in his pen all day. It was time to go get him out of his pen. And I go to open the door, and it doesn't look like my hand reaching for the doorknob, you know, and I can sort of function, but I feel so disconnected that I don't really trust myself. This lasted pretty much all night. It was actually quite scary. It kind of freaked me out a little bit. And because I've never had them last that long. Usually if I can go to bed for a couple, 3 hours, when I get up, I feel like crap for quite a while, but I don't have it that bad. And this lasted until I went to bed last night. And I've slept, I think I went to bed, after sleeping most of the day, I went to bed at 8:30 or 9, and I didn't get up until 10:30 this morning. And I do feel a lot better, but I'm still not 100%. I still have I would call it a light brain fog. So this video is actually a little bit of a plea. If any of you out there have had experience with this kind of a migraine that affects so much of your sensory inputs, you know, your vision and your sense of touch, and even that brain fog, I'd be interested in touching base and just sharing experiences. But certainly if any of you have any experience with anything that helps, I'd really, really appreciate, you know, even if it's just an area, an avenue that I might research further. Because, of course, the medical professions haven't been much help to me. I'm just about to jump in the truck and go to a walk-in clinic and just sort of roll the dice and see if the doctor there can, you know, has got any insight. I've sort of done that over the years. My family doctor takes so long to get into that by the time I can get a scheduled appointment, I'm so far beyond the migraine. It doesn't much matter, I don't think. And the few times I have spoken to my family doctor about the symptoms, he is visibly scared. And that doesn't make me feel very confident. You know, he looks shaken. And it's like, listen, I'm the one who should be shaken here. Anyway, he's never been much help. So I'm going to roll the dice and go to a walk-in clinic and just see if I get a doctor that's maybe had more experience than any others. And if not, well, then I'm just going to have to see what other research I can do on the net. Because I'm at the point now where even though I've had these since I was a kid, I'm really, really sick of them. And it does scare me a little bit that it seems to be changing. Now, in the last bunch of years, it seemed to be changing in a good way. It seemed to be lessening. And my mom used to get migraines, and now she doesn't anymore. So there's been some hope in me that maybe my migraines would morph to that point as well, where they just wouldn't be. But the last two that I've had have been scarier than I've had for quite some while, and they seem to last longer. So this is definitely something I'd like to see if I can make some progress with. And of course, it impacts my ability to think straight and my ability to even desire to do research and make video uploads. And so it's definitely something that I like to get nipped in the bud. As for now, I'm going to try to enjoy the rest of my day. I go back to work tomorrow, so I'm going to try and use the rest of today as recuperation and get a good early night's sleep tonight again. But again, if any of you have had any experience in this same kind of migraine or have any ideas, thoughts, areas to research, I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching.